Welcome to our deep dive into Microsoft's Semantic Kernel. In the next 10 minutes, we'll explore what Semantic Kernel is and how you can get started with it. Imagine your app as a living entity. Semantic Kernel is the technology that gives your app a simulated brain and a responsive body. The brain, powered by a suite of connectors, allows your app to remember interactions and learn over time. The body, formed by AI plugins, interacts with the real world through prompts and actions. With Semantic Kernel, integrating AI services becomes a breeze. Think of it as giving your app the ability to think and act within its environment, making it smarter and more autonomous. As a developer, you can use these pieces individually or together. For example, if you just need an abstraction over OpenAI and Azure OpenAI services, you could use the SDK to just run pre-configured prompts within your plugins. But the real power of Semantic Kernel comes from combining these components together. But what does this mean for you? It means that you can orchestrate AI plugins from anywhere. OpenAI, Bing, Microsoft 365 Copilot, Azure, or Hugging Face, all within your app's architecture. All right, let's roll up our sleeves and see Semantic Kernel in action. Okay, so I'm gonna make a GitHub repo for this tutorial series. We're gonna start from scratch. Link is in the description below. So first we're gonna start with installing the dependencies. I assume you already got Python. Then go to the terminal and install the Semantic Kernel. It's straightforward from there. I have already installed it, so I won't run it again. After installing the Semantic Kernel, let's install the Semantic Kernel tools. Open up VS Code and install the Semantic Kernel tools plugin. It's gonna make our life easier when making functions. Now that we have all we need, it's time to make semantic functions. So in our project folder, I'll start by making a plugin folder for our functions and create another folder inside plugins for the specific skills. For this, we will do cooking.
That's good.
Put another random folder as well for later. Now we're gonna use the Semantic Kernel tools. So we're gonna make a new function, create a new skill folder for the function. I'll choose the cooking folder for this. For the name of the function, we will use recipe generator. Then we will add the description of the function. It will basically take in an input and output a recipe for the given dish. Now that we have all we need, it's time to make semantic functions. There will be an skprompt.txt file where we will add the prompts for our semantic functions. So I will go ahead and edit the input. As you can see, the $ input variable is basically the value we pass on to the function. Then we can also add extra variables. For now, ignore the extra variables we will go into on the next video.
Subscribe to my channel.
These are prompts that will be sent to OpenAI.
Wow!
For this, we will ask ChatGPT to provide a recipe for the input given by the user. And if the user provided a format, it will provide it in that format. Now that we have all our semantic functions, it's time to make our Python program. Okay, so I'm gonna just call this the starter file. So, we will first import the semantic kernel and the necessary libraries. Let's instantiate the kernel. Then let's import the libraries for chat services. In this tutorial, we will use the OpenAI chat completion. Add the chat service with the model we want. For this, we use GPT 3.5. Now that we imported and instantiated
everything,
we will need to make a .env file. In the file, add your OpenAI API keys and org ID. Now let's get back to the main file. So let's import the functions we have made earlier. We will add the folder plugins and cooking. Let's name our function the recipe function and import the recipe generator function we made earlier. Let's print out the output of the function. I want to know the recipe of chicken adobo Filipino style, cause you know that hit hard. Now we will run the program. So let's run this in Python. You can see it sends the prompts to OpenAI. Finally, we got the recipe to chicken adobo. Congrats, you just made your first semantic kernel application in less than 5 minutes. Now let me show you why we can use this beyond the basics of sending prompts to ChatGPT. So we will make another semantic function called advert. We will run the recipe function and store the output into a variable that we will pass into the advert function. The end result should be an advertisement for the recipe. Does this sound familiar? Yes, it is like chaining with LangChain. Making the function would be the same process as earlier. Let's use the semantic kernel tools. Let's add a description for the function. Let's add our prompt. You can use my prompts or you can make your own if you're good in prompt engineering. Now let's get back to the main file. First, let me rename skill to cooking skill. Let's edit this too. Now we will make a marketing skill and import the marketing folder. We will now add the advert function that we have made. After that, we will run the recipe function and store the result to a variable. Now let's run the advert function and store it into a variable too. Let's print both results. Great. Now let's run the program and see if we get the desired result we want. We must be able to first output the recipe, then output the advertisement generated from the recipe. Oh wait, there's a bug.
Oh no.
Caught it. Yeah, so make sure you got the name of the functions right. Now let's run it again. Perfect. We got the output of the recipe function. We passed that into the advert function, and we got the output of the advert function printed out. Nice. We got a recipe and an advertisement. Congrats. You have used the semantic kernel in less than 7 minutes. You can now experiment with it and build a full pipeline for your LLM applications. I recommend checking out their GitHub repo to see more of its capabilities. I will be posting more tutorials on the semantic kernel as well. So make sure to subscribe. If this video helped, please like for the algo. If you have any insights, positive comments, or negative comments, please comment below. If you don't have any, comment below your favorite food, and maybe I will cook you one. Thank you for watching.